But you know, there's. Do you think that that when you're putting those things in the diary, that you're thinking that someday they're going to be published?
Oh, no, no, I'm not thinking like that. No, I am keeping it in a therapeutic sense. I want for myself, in case I ever do have to write something about my life, and know then, you know, what periods things happened in, I want them for that purpose. I want them for a record for myself. I don't want them read by other people. No, I don't want that.
What's the saddest thing when you read them that you find in your diary?
The continually occurs in mine. Oh, is depression, yes. Because again and again, one does go to the diary to relieve it. And so again and again, I'm writing things like, I feel dreadful, looked in the mirror and thought, you know, what is this wretched old face ever going to accomplish? That kind of feeling of desuetude and total dreariness. I put all that in. And looking back on some of it, I think, oh, really, you did go too far. But that's not true. One actually felt that at the time. Mm. One did feel utterly dreary.
What, you mean, like, say, you'd want to kill yourself or something like that?
Oh, yes, I put stuff like down about suicide and how one would go about it, what would be the best method and all that kind of thing, you know. Why looking back on it, of course, it's often, you know, quite amusing.
Why do you think you want to kill yourself?
Well, one would think it at the time because of extremely low state of morale. And one actually does write something down which is practical in terms of how one thinks one should go about it.
Mm, right. Now, would you comment on your looks in your diary?
Oh, yes, I continually do comment on my looks in the diary. I've actually written down, look quite well, and I've bought new overcoat, fancy myself in it, and all that sort of thing. I've put lots about my appearance in the diary, yes.
Now, do you make assessments about yourself in your diary?
Oh, yes, I put down things like, was good in such and such a show, or was bad, or this role isn't me, or something or other, or about the rows I've had with, say, directors in the show. I put all that kind of thing down, yes, absolutely.
Do you put down things that are against you in your diary?
Yes, I have. I've looked back and seen stuff which is ludicrous, really. I put down once, left the television centre feeling triumphant, because I had gone quite well in a particular show I'd done. And I put down, but as I passed down the corridor, someone blew a raspberry. And I looked back to see who'd done it. All the doors were closed. They'd obviously hidden. And I put down, this is a reprehensible thing to do. As though it was all, you know, something should be owned up about. This is the sort of rubbish, you know, that one does consign to paper. Yes, I put in my diary that I have a great affection for my cap and that I go down Baker Street wearing it. And I wrote in it once that I was sneered at by some people in this cap, and somebody said it looks like an old flasher's outfit, my raincoat and cap. And Barbara Windsor said to me afterwards, it does, it's really disgusting, and I know them people in that Hartnell shop, and they say you're always walking by in this dreadful gear. Why don't you buy something decent? And I put all that down as a reflection on my appearance. You know, by the...
Do you think that your... handwriting has changed a lot during
the years. Oh, enormously, over the years, yes. And in fact, day to day. Because I don't know if you can see this, for instance, this one. This is one of the latest of mine. Can you see that? Can they see that?
Yes.
Can you see that? Now, there you see you've got one kind of writing. See? And then you'll notice the different colours. Oh, you can't see. Is it in colour, this? Oh, they can see. Some of it's in different colours, Mavis. You see, because I put in red. Do you see that?
Yes.
That in red, yes, is always about illness. You see, rash on chin, am horrified. That's all in red. So I recognise immediately when I come to look back on my state of health by going straight to the red entries. But that, you see, looks pretty consistent as far as writing is concerned. And then one will go on and it will appear to be consistent. And then it will alter there, you see, completely, in a much finer kind of handwriting, which does indicate, as far as I'm concerned, that I was more confident. The finer the writing gets, the smaller the lettering, the more confident I
really
become.
Really? Your handwriting, yes, changes with your moods a
lot.
Oh,
absolutely. If I'm feeling absolutely volatile and a bit nervy and uninhibited, it becomes much more florid and round. But if I am careful and precise and diligent, the writing reflects that and becomes small and well-formed.